Welcome back to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Ottman. We continue this special episode interviewing the university officials working hard on our return to campus this fall. Now we talk with Dr. Mark Byrnes, University Provost and Chair of the COVID-19 Task Force devoted to our plans to return to campus. Well, Provost Byrnes, thanks for joining us on the program again, and we always appreciate seeing you.
Glad to be here.
We've got a lot to talk about. Obviously, the start of the fall semester upon us. And I know that there are a lot of questions about new terms that have come up on student schedules describing the classes they're about to take. I was hoping you could go through those five different categories of what we call the classes and briefly touch upon what they mean.
Right. It's a little confusing, I know, to some students because we're taking definitions we had pre-COVID and then adding some more class definitions as we responded to the crisis. So we do have five categories, conventional, which are the traditional on-ground, all-the-time classes, online, which are also have been around for a while. They're totally online. There's no ground, on-ground meetings at all, and the work is done asynchronously. That is, whenever you want to and not at the same time as the rest of the class. Then there's remote, which is also totally online, no on-ground meetings, but may or may not be synchronous. That is, your professor might choose to do some Zoom sessions during the regularly scheduled class time. So in looking at the class schedule, you'll see that a lot of those remote classes have times associated with them. That's really a cue to the students that they need to save those times because the professor might want to do some things synchronously. Then there are hybrid and web-assisted, both of which are partly on-ground and partly online. The primary difference being how many hours of on-ground meetings are there. For hybrid, it's less than 15. For web-assisted, it's 15 or more. So that's it in a nutshell. You can go to our website, mtsu.edu/registration, I think is what it is. Yeah, registration. /fall 2020, and you see a really nice explanation of what all of those mean and some examples of what those classes look like.
You're right. That's a lot of new information and a lot of new terms. But the key thing is, obviously, we're trying very, very hard to make wise decisions about how we meet in person, why we meet in person, and really doing this in a way to keep the campus as safe as possible, but also just to make sure that we can continue to mitigate the virus effect and continue to do these person-to-person instructions when most important, right?
Right, our challenge from the beginning of the pandemic has been how to pursue these two objectives, maintaining educational quality, mitigating risk from the virus. How do we maximize both of those? And so it's been a balancing act and will continue to be as the virus evolves as to how we do that. But what we've settled on for fall are these mix of classes, bringing the classes where it makes the most sense on ground and putting others either fully or partly online. So it's been a big puzzle to try to figure out how to do all of that. The faculty and the chairs and the deans have done a great job, I think. Everyone, all students will not be happy with it. I understand that, but we have done the best we could while we keep in mind those two goals of educational quality and risk mitigation.
I know we say this all the time. I teach a class and I say this all the time. Now more than ever, read the syllabus, right? And make sure that you're listening to how the professor is going to describe how your course is going to be taught, because it's not going to be the same type of experience you had during the last switch to remote learning that we did after spring break in the spring semester, but it's certainly not going to be like we had it in the previous fall semester last year.
No, it's going to be a totally new animal because it's not a traditional semester. There's no sense in pretending that it is going to be, but it's also not an unexpected, almost immediate switch like it was last spring. We've had some time to prepare for it, and maybe not as much time as we'd like, but we are as prepared as we can be under the circumstances.
Provost Byrnes, you've made some significant investment in technology for the classrooms. Can you talk through some of those things that you've added and what you hope it'll accomplish?
Sure. The big thing is the installation of what we call lecture capture technology in our classrooms. And the goal being, as the term suggests, to capture what goes on in that class session on video and then to upload it to the D2L shell of the course so that if a student misses a class, he or she can go to that D2L site and access that material.
We're going to be having classes in a lot of spaces that really weren't classrooms last semester or previous semesters. Walk me through the strategy that you're doing to ensure social distancing in those learning environments.
Well, so part of the changes we did for this fall were to go through all of our classrooms and figure out what the COVID capacity is. That is, how many students can be in the classroom while maintaining 6 feet of distance from everybody. And so that was a pretty big job. We've got more than 450 classrooms. And so we determined what the capacity was and looked at how big the classes are, what format they were going to be taught in, and then put all that together. What we knew from the beginning, though, was that some particularly big classes were going to have to move, because in order to get 6 feet of space, you're giving up a lot of seats in the classroom. And so our biggest rooms will now hold 120 people at one time. Those will be three spaces we set up in the ballroom in the Student Union building, which is a really large space. We'll convert it for the fall to classroom space. And there are other spaces around campus that will also be utilized, the Tennessee room in the James Union building and others as class space. But we're doing everything we can to provide on-campus space for those courses that for which it's appropriate. And we'll see how it goes. I'm optimistic that it's going to work pretty well, but it's going to require adjustments on all sides, really.
Well, Provost Mark Byrnes, Chair of the Task Force on our Return to Campus for the Fall. Dr. Byrnes, thanks for joining us on the show. We appreciate your time.
Yeah, happy to be here.
And we'll be right back.